Hi, everybody. Happy Sunday. It is time for another weekly bullet journal setup. It is the week where we'll be planning out March 15th through the 21st. If you're on the replay, hi, I'm glad that you're here. And if you are here for the live, I'm also glad that you're here. I currently have some Topo Chico mineral water in here. It's the grapefruit flavor. I've decided I really like it more than some of the other options because it's the bubbles are like really intense and I like that. So that's what I'm drinking right now. And I also have I've been chomping on like a quickly toasted ham and cheese sandwich that I made right after my patron hangout because I was hungry and I did take my potassium. So let's get going on the week. And this week I will also be, while I'm setting my week up, I will be answering some prompts. I asked for your ideas, like your, like I put like, what are my top three? And then blank. And then you gave me top three X. So for example, the first one on here is top three Jelly Belly flavors. I actually don't have any because I don't like jelly beans. So so the second one is top three road trip destinations. For me, that would be Bend, Oregon, because that is my favorite place to go. And then Mendocino on the coast, the city of Mendocino, that's where the kids' summer camp is. And I always love driving out there with Jesse, even though it's a long, twisty drive. And then basically anywhere with my kids and Jesse. So anyway. Ooh, Indie Kitty. Thank you for the super chat, $5. How is moving going to impact visitation for my kids? Let me swap over really quick to my bullet journal and we'll start talking. So I'm not going to go too deeply into that right now because we are still hammering out some of the final details. And it's not quite appropriate time yet, but they will be coming with us full time and then seeing their dad for like holidays and long weekends and summertime and things like that. But we don't know all of the full details yet. But the, ooh, there's a siren. So, but they will be moving as their primary residence with us to Denver. I will be talking more about that in detail as time goes on. It's just not quite the time to talk about that yet. So before I get going, I'm going to do the same kind of spread that I've been doing these situations, but instead of doing a, like cutting the page, I'm going to take this page that was cut from a previous one and glue it in as a tip-in. So, or not glue it in, but like washi tape it in as a tip-in. And so then I'm going to be like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, like that. So that's what I'm going to be doing. And I packed most of my washi already. I kept out a few of the neutral Amanda Rach Lee washies because I figured that they would be the most versatile. And I need to justify buying them because I spent good money on them, man. Oh, I think I'll use this one. No, I'll use this one, I think will work. Jack in the Box is not my absolute favorite, but I might do that. I'm gonna have to probably do like In-N-Out Burger before we go. Although I did find out recently that that Denver has a bunch of Raising Cane's, which has become one of my favorite things ever. So when I went to New Orleans, so I am excited for that. All right, let me get this cut. Okay, so I don't want to do the whole thing because I feel like that would be too much tape. Ooh, hello from the UK. I don't really care for Jack in the Box tacos. They are too greasy for me. But then again, one of my favorite, like I'm on the rag and my, I need like hardcore like sustenance in that situation, Taco Bell tacos make me really happy. And so I recognize that bitching about Jack in the Box tacos while enjoying Taco Bell tacos during that time of the month is not exactly the most, what did I do here? Not exactly the most like suave way to go about it. Okay, this is becoming a situation. So I'm just gonna, oh no. No, stay together. We got this, little friend. We got this. Okay, here. Nope, stay together. I'm trying to put the the two rounded sides together so that when it folds in, it looks like the rounded sides. Yeah, my potassium is super low. For some K2000H, it's a really good question being curious as to why my potassium, why while I'm in kidney, like, and I'm not in kidney failure just yet, I am, but I am very close. But yeah, it's, my potassium is hella low, so I'm actually on a huge amount of potassium supplements. And I, my nephrologist thinks it might have something to do with the genetic variation of PKD that I have, because my sister and my grandmother both also dealt with low potassium. My sister especially. So there is that. It is definitely not the norm in kidney disease to have low potassium at this stage, at stage four and stage, late stage four, early stage five. It is not at all the norm. Okay, that was a lot more stressful than I thought it was going to be, but we're just going to do it one more time because I want to make sure that this is secure. How did the book decluttering go? Well, it went great. It went better than I thought it was would. The biggest problem I ran into was not with the decluttering, but with how much bending and everything else it took. I just wound up being like wrecked afterwards. If you were on the book club live stream, you knew that I was fucking wrecked. Okay, where's my bone folder? Bone folder. Let's give this a little foldy fold. To kind of crease it. Low potassium, it's not, low potassium is good in the sense that I get to eat as many potatoes as I want, but it is not good in the sense that it can mess with my blood pressure and other things. Like, you want normal potassium. My potassium actually just kind of creeped into the very lowest of normal, but my nephrologist still wants me on all of the supplements because it's not, it's like just barely touching normal. Yeah. Did I see Archer and Olive's SH? No. All right. So we got this done. So this is going to be the spread. It's going to be this situation right here. Let me move that a little bit. There we go. I feel like that was throwing some weirdness. New sub box with the letter size bullet journal. I did not, but that's cool. Although I wouldn't want the paper, but that's pretty fucking rad. No worries. Anyway, my nose, I'm a little runny. Okay, let's pick up some more of these top threes and then I'll start drawing some of this in. Top three dog breeds. Honestly, I don't really have a lot of top three dog breeds because I've never really been like, I guess I'm, two of them would be Labrador Retrievers and Golden Retrievers because those are the kinds of dogs we're going to be looking for once we settle into Denver and the cats have settled in. And then I guess number three, ever since I was a little kid, the dog I was fascinated with is a Cocker Spaniel in it because of Lady and the Tramp. Like, that's it. It was because of Lady and the Tramp. How many books did I get rid of? Lots. You'll see, I'm going to have a video up this week. So I probably got rid of as many as I wanted to get rid of, although I didn't completely finish because there were a few shelves of mostly Jesse's books, and he made it very clear to me he wants to take care of that himself. Okay, top three places you want to visit. I want to visit, does Europe count? I mean, I really would like to go, if I had to pick three cities, London, Paris, and Florence, Italy. Those are the three cities I would like to visit. Mostly because of, like, historic stuff and museums and all that good shit. Okay, let's see here. Monday. Your porridge now has 6 spoons of sugar in it. Good times. Oh, is a basset hound the one that looks like, what was the dog in Tiny Toons that was like a hound dog, but every time it laid down, it like spread out everywhere. It like was a liquid dog. Whatever that dog is, I know it's a kind of hound dog. I just don't know what kind of hound dog it is. I was always fascinated by those as well. Kelly, my husband has been doing massive researching on our breeds and looking at breed. He's been taking care of all of that. He's in charge of the dog search. So, okay. Fizzy beverages. Oh, fucking Dr. Pepper, which I have mostly given up because of the phosphorus, even though technically I'm low on that too. So there is that. But, yeah, Dr. Pepper, this new Topo Chico fixation I have is up there for fizzy beverages, and Prosecco when it doesn't make me feel like shit. The Bassett was the short, long one from Long Ears from the... Okay, cool. Holy shit, Molly. That's intense. I'm glad I'm not there yet. Top three drinks, LOL. So... taking, like, if you're talking about adult beverages, I'll just go with that. Mimosas, because those are the only alcoholic beverage that I can seem to have that don't make me feel completely like ass. Long Island iced teas have been a longtime favorite of mine, although I would not touch one right now for the life of me because I would imagine that it would totally fuck me up. And other adult beverage. I really, really like a frozen, like, blended strawberry margarita. I love me a frozen blended strawberry margarita with no salt. No salt on the margaritas. Somebody else said top three fancy drinks when out and about. Starbucks preferred. I actually don't get very fancy Starbucks drinks. My favorite drink is a summer drink at Starbucks. I love me a Trenta unsweetened white iced tea with extra ice. And then I love I really like that pumpkin spice cold brew this last pumpkin spice season. I'm not a big fan of pumpkin spice lattes. Hold on, I need to turn my phone, keep my phone from turning off for the I'm gonna put my face on here. I guess you can kind of see me working on this. I need to turn my phone, do the thing where it doesn't like turn off right away because auto lock 30 seconds. How about we do never for the, duration of this live stream because it keeps locking and I have to keep holding it up with my face. All right, so I said Starbucks drinks I'm giving you are unsweetened white iced tea with extra ice Trenta, a pumpkin spice cold brew, and then I also am really enjoying just like a basic like matcha latte with half of the pumps of sweetener. Whatever size I get, I just cut the sweetener in half. With just regular milk. Or with almond milk if I'm feeling spicy. Top three snack foods. Cheez-Its. Right off the bat. Cheez-Its. Okay, this is, this might, some of you might not even think about, but like Crunch and Munch. Have you ever had that shit? It's like the Crunch and Munch is like the, it's like the toffee popcorn with peanuts in it. Oh, kind of like, it's better than Cracker Jack, I'm just going to say. Brown sugar oat milk shaken espresso. That sounds goddamn good, Emily. I'm going to have to check that one out. You've never had Vegemite, but you don't think you would like the texture. I don't know what the texture of Vegemite is, but I hella enjoy Marmite. Marmite is goddamn delicious, and you cannot tell me otherwise. If you eat it the right way, on a piece of toast with butter and then a scrape of the Marmite across the toast, chef's kiss. I do the California version of Marmite, though, and I have it on sourdough toast. And that is one thing I'm worried about moving to Denver. My kids are actually worried about this, too. We are all worried about access to sourdough bread. We have been in New York, like, sourdough at the delis is, like, not an option. And we are all sourdough lovers in this household. So, I the extra toasty Cheez-Its are amazing. 10 out of 10, those ones are really good. But I went through a phase where the extra toasty Cheez-Its were my favorite, but I think I am defaulting back to the regular Cheez-Its because I don't know. I just am. That's just the kind of place that I'm in. I fucking love Marmite. You can't even make me. Yeah, they're spreadable. It's like a, it kind of looks like Nutella, but it tastes nothing like Nutella. Nothing like Nutella. Crazy Ex-Girlfriend songs or scenes. I have never seen Crazy Ex-Girlfriend. I saw the movie with Uma Thurman in it once, but that's all. Markers. My favorite markers. Tombow dual brush markers, Pitt artist pens, and the Crayola Super Tips, I think, are coming up as a close. Although those dot markers, they're like the honorable mention right now. The last week's setup turned out great, Gloria. Looks good. I didn't really do a good job checking my blood pressure last week, though. Reunion bread. Once you get to Denver, let me write that down because this is important information. Okay, anyway, moving forward. Gel pens. I really like the Pilot G2. And I love the Uniball Signo, the Broad, for specific things and for writing with, actually. I used to love writing with the Uniball Signo Broad Tip. Not as much anymore, but I did. And then the Energel. The Pentel Energel Clena 05 is my, like, love. Lovely, lovely love. I'll have to watch. I've heard Crazy Ex-Girlfriend is really good. I've just never watched. Favorite, top three favorite authors. Stephen King. Oh, God. Stephen King. Antonia Fraser, who is not a fiction author. She is a historian. And I love her biographies. And I guess on that same note, Jeff Gwynn is now one of my current, like, in terms of every book I've read of his being one that I absolutely fucking love. Yes. George R.R. Martin was one of my favorite authors, but I am resentful of him right now because he's still not done with A Song of Ice and Fire. So I'm not gonna, that's just the way I live my life. And Kicking It Back Old School, fucking love the shit out of V.C. Andrews and the V.C. Andrews Ghostwriter. Not because I think I believe his name was Andrew, the V.C. Andrews ghostwriter. Not like I think that the books are, like, phenomenal, but they are fucking fun to read. Like, and that to me is more important than a book being good, is if it's fun. What about favorite bold point pens? Oh, I'm trying a new one, and I think I did not. Oh, fuck. It's like a uni something or another, but I don't have it with me, but I've been testing it. This one, Uni Sign Pen, is one. It's like, look at this. Look how just juicy this is. Oh, it's so compared. Like, oh, I love it. This is what I've been testing. It's like a felt-tipped pen, and I love it. That one and the Pigma Micron 1, the Graphic Liner 1, is amazing for really bold. And for slightly less bold, I am loving the Pilot fineliners. There's a Lifetime movie of My Sweet Audrina. I need to watch it. I have heard about it, but I have not seen. I did watch all of the Heaven and Flowers in the Attic movies, though. The Heaven ones made me sad because they did not go there as much. And Troy was just nowhere near as cute as he was supposed to be. He was cute, but he wasn't as cute. You know what I'm saying? All right, favorite watercolor paints. Currently, my absolute favorite watercolor paints are the Regina's watercolors, both because I love her actual paints and because she has a glass mixing palette that I fucking love. I'm also really enjoying the Munio paints and the colors of Daniel Smith that I have. I love the granulation of them. So those are the ones I'm at right now. Let's see here. We've got fiction books. Top three. Oh, that's hard. My favorite book of all time is It by Stephen King. I don't think it's my favorite book ever, but I probably have reread it more than most books that I own based on how much it's falling apart, and that is The Other Bolin Girl. That was my introduction to historical fiction, and that was before the movies came out. Or the movie came out. And then other favorite fiction book. Probably A Storm of Swords by George R.R. Martin. Fucking love the shit out of that book. Rebecca asks, top three ways to piss away a beautiful free day. Reading, which is not really, none of these are really pissing it away, but that's what I've done. Reading, binge watching a TV series, and playing Animal Crossing. Hi, sweetheart.
Hey. I finally resolved the laptop issue.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
That's what you've been doing? Would you get me a ginger ale?
Yeah, I just spent over an hour on the phone with customer service.
I'll
get you a ginger ale.
Thank you. I'm drinking this Topo Chico, but my stomach is really upset right now, so I would like ginger ale help settle it down. House decor items, top three house decor items that you own. I don't know, man. My Michael Myers painting, number one. My Michael Myers oil painting. Number two of house decor items that I own would be my side-eye Steve giant plushy pillow that Kristen gave me on my bed, along with all of my really nice looking bedding. I just fucking love it. And okay, this is gonna sound like super wanky, but I really love having my entire series one of my fuckery flowers hanging up in the dining room. And as a matter of fact, our realtor told us we should leave those on the wall to stage the house. Yeah, she actually bought one of them when she came over. She came over to drop a pie off or something for Thanksgiving a couple years ago. And she walked in and saw them and bought one of the sunflower ones off me right off on the spot. So,
sunflower's the best one, if you ask me.
And we're not going to be opening the shop till after we move. And I just confirmed that by packing up all of the inventory. So,
somebody wants to make one very large purchase. Sell all the inventory.
All right, so let's see. I got a couple in the chat here. We've got top three from Sonia, top three favorite actors. Nicolas Cage. Nicolas Cage. Who else? Do I have any other favorite actors? Oh my God, right now, Matthew Good, the dude who's in The Discovery of Witches and he was in The Crown. I really enjoy him. I think he is suave as a motherfucker. And then I really like Janelle Monáe as an actor. She's one of my favorite, like I love her music, but I actually really love her as an actor too. So there is that. Ooh, hi from Brooklyn. Top Netflix series. Do I have a lot of Netflix series?
Tiger King.
Bridgerton. I just watched that. And The Crown, I guess. So it's not necessarily, I think they're the best series on Netflix, but I don't remember what other Netflix, like, specific series. Like, The Tudors is always on Netflix, but that's not a Netflix series. But if you want to watch the series that I have watched the most, like, rewatched the most, it would be The Tudors. Jesse and I have watched The Tudors through probably, like, a million times at this point.
It's one of the cornerstones of our relationship.
Yeah,
you know?
It is. That's 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Dream projects. What kind of projects?
Dream projects.
Like in general or for like work? Okay, so for one, I would love to have a line of wallpapers available at like Target or like mass produced. I would love to have a line of wallpapers. That to me is a dream project. I would love to be able to let's see. I think I only have two real big dream projects, and one of them is the line of wallpapers, and the other one is to write a book, not a lettering book or a doodling book, which I've already written and I'm very glad, but like a getting a kidney donated from somebody from the planner community, which we're working on, hopefully, fingers crossed, and writing a book about that, because I think that that would be a really awesome perspective on the power of online communities. Okay. So if you haven't seen this spread before, I got this from Yukiri Studies on Instagram. This is a time tracking spread, and each of these hash marks is 10 minutes. So you can see here, filling it out with the different colors of my different situations that I've color coded here, just represents different amounts of time. And I'm really liking it so far. It's holding me accountable really well. Top three favorite swear words. Fuck, fuckery, and bullshittery.
I feel like fuckery should count as like a conjugation.
It's a different word. All right, so we're gonna go back to some of the ones from Instagram. We've got Nicolas Cage movies. Con Air. By far. Fucking Peggy Sue Got Married, going back to the old school. And then the best movie of all time. Jesse knows what it is. Face Off. Fucking love that movie. I saw that movie thrice in the theater when it came out. Fucking love Face Off. Top three mildliner colors. The light gray, the dark gray, and the coral. Let me rephrase. The light gray, the summer green, and the coral. Barbara is asking, are you tracking or planning with the time blocking? I'm tracking. And it's not a perfect tracking, but it's mostly a way. What I found is when I time track, I hold myself accountable because I don't want it to look like a bunch of like tomfoolery. I tend to be more responsible when I time track. And so I'm trying to get work done for the move every single day without cannibalizing my work time. And so, because that's really easy for me to do, is... Jesse knows that. Oh, Loki, you're not supposed to be on the box, you guys. Oh, boy. Here we go. Let me move. Is he getting down?
No.
No. Loki's on one of my boxes. You guys can see my kitty right there. There's my kitty and my husband. Okay, now we're done. Moving forward.
I wonder which box he'll fall into first.
You saw Con Air when it was filming outside your workplace? That's fucking rad, Mary. So my time tracking is mostly meant to be a way to hold myself accountable. So what I'm gonna do, what I think I'm gonna do is just do the one task list this week, and then, if I need more space, I can always make another list. And then I'm going to put meal plans and blood pressure to give myself a little bit more room. And then I think I'm going to draw another thing, or maybe I'll leave that blank and add a drawing during the live plan with me next week if I don't need it for a to-do list. All right. Yeah. Exactly, Barbara. I think I might use it for planning at some point, but I actually do kind of planning like that in my Google Calendar. So, all right. So what do we got? Books of 2020. Oh, fuck if I know. I'm not even going to go. I can't even. My brain is nowhere near ready for that. Let me think about that. YouTube channels to binge. Evelyn from the internets. God damn it. Some of her shit is so fucking funny. Who else do I binge?
The two women who talk about their virtues all the time.
He's talking about Amy Landino. What was the one? I have been binging this one channel, and I don't know what the name of the channel is, but they put on a bunch of, like, British documentaries. There's a couple of them. There's one that does a bunch of documentaries about the current royal family, and there's one that does a bunch of documentaries about the, previous, like, different, like, anything from Henry VIII to Edward III to whatever. Like, those, like, hour-long historical documentaries that somebody uploads to YouTube. I have been binging the shit out of those, and anything that has to do with ballerinas customizing their point shoes. All right, so backwards Sunday, Saturday, Friday, Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday. Woohoo! Okay. Top three moments in history, Jessica says. Oh, I don't know. I don't know, man. That's big. It's a big thing to figure out. My brain is not that don't ask me that on a day when it's daylight savings time. Top three Disney films. Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, and Finding Nemo. Jesse knows me.
I feel like I could answer some of these with 66% accuracy.
60% of the time it works every time. Top three favorite jobs, Jessica asks, that I've had, or jobs in general. That I've had, being a cake decorator. I've only had a handful of jobs, but I really loved being a cake decorator, and I loved being a sign artist, and I really loved working in my grandma's daycare. That, like, as an assistant, that was so much fun. But if it was jobs I've wanted in my life, the top three jobs I've wanted in my life, it is geneticist, marine biologist, and FBI agent. Can you wonder what, like, show I was super into? Top three songs to clean by. I can just give you an album. Madonna's True Blue. My sisters and I would put that album on, and that was our house cleaning album. The whole album. La Isla Bonita. Top three figure skaters. Scott Hamilton, because yes. And then pairs skating, I've really gotten into, like, the dancing. So Virtue and Moyer and what's the American couple? Charlie and what's her name? Oh my God, I can picture them. There's Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer, and then there's the other one, the other couple that was really famous with ice dancing at the same time. I really like them, and I could picture Meryl. It's Meryl and Charlie, but I cannot remember their last names for the life of me. So them. Top three historic eras. Okay, I can do that, Jessica. I love reading about the Wars of the Roses. I love reading about the Tudor era, and I love reading about the era with the Henrys, the earlier Henrys, Henry the Fourth, Henry the Fifth, Henry the Third, Henry the Fourth, Henry the Fifth. That area with, like, all that, and also Henry the Second, because isn't he the one who was married to Eleanor of Aquitaine? Like, those early eras. Deb asks, top three musicals. Rent. That I've seen or that I love. Rent, Hadestown, and Little Shop of Horrors. Hamilton? No, Little Shop of Horrors. Hamilton is fabulous, but Little Shop of Horrors is
top three for you, huh?
It's so good.
See, 66% accuracy.
Top three favorite places to eat in Napa. Well, one of them's not in Napa. It's up valley, but Sushi Mambo. Fuck yeah.
That's not in Napa.
It counts. It's my favorite. And
loves
actually
it so much.
And then also up valley, not in Napa, but in Rutherford, is La Luna. It's a Mexican grocery store with, like, a thing in the back, and their quesadillas are fucking bomb. And then actually in Napa is the grilled cheese place downtown that does grilled cheeses on waffles, melted. Oh,
I think
so good.
To name two honorable mentions in Napa.
Two honorable mentions
in
Napa.
Two places that aren't in Napa.
Okay, two honorable.
No, it's like RJ doing his homework.
Two honorable mentions in Napa would be Haven, which is a takeout only wings place and is hella fucking good. And then all of our food has been takeout this last year. No, ever since I found out about the owner guy sucking at major ass, I just cannot. I can eat there sometimes to support the people we know who work there, but I'm not really a huge fan of it anymore. The fuck is that? Emmy's Diner. It's a great breakfast place.
Really?
Emilou's Diner. It's a like breakfast place in one of the shopping centers in town. But their breakfast is yummy and it's inexpensive for what you get. Mm-hmm. Charlie White and Meryl Davis. Thank you, Grace. Holy shit. Okay. Top pet peeves. People who microwave their coffee right after they clock in for work.
Whoops. Sorry.
When people don't put the pillows on the bed the way they're supposed to go.
I feel attacked.
And when people put their dishes in the sink instead of in the dishwasher when the dishwasher is empty. What about that pizza place? Papa Joe's. Papa Joe's is also really delicious, but the pizza is good, but it's not why I love them the most because of their ranch, and that's the thing I'm going to miss the most when we move is the ranch. Three most useful things to store your supplies in, Donna says. Fucking pouches. I am... No. Okay. No. These containers from the dollar store. There's a whole bunch of different sizes of them, but they're cheap and they're really well made. And then these containers that I got from the Target dollar spot, they're pretty if you get the right colors of them. Excuse me. They often have different colors to match whatever. And then if you had an office, Jessica, I don't think it's as big of a deal, but when you work at a grocery store and you clock in and you're supposed to get right to work, having somebody wander back to the break room and then microwave their coffee right after they clock in, it's not the business. I think in an office, it's a little different. And then I am a huge fan of pouches. So, and then things that I wish I hadn't wasted the money on, like not useful or wish I hadn't bought. I really hate Copic multiliners, I've decided. The tips just do not work well for my heavy-handedness. And they were expensive. And then any kind of cheap cakey watercolors where you're like, it's cheap. Like the Michaels ones, that giant set of colors from Artist Loft. I fucking hate those. Not worth the money I spent on them, and the money was not that much. And then any paintbrush where the hairs fall out. I'm going to get a couple more from Instagram right now. We've got top three favorite pizza toppings, extra cheese and pepperoni and cheese.
And cheese. Extra cheese.
Yeah, I like either cheese or pepperoni pizza. I'm not exactly a, adventurous pizza eater. I'm starting to put my weather in, by the way. It's going to be rainy this week. Woohoo! California really needs it. Or Napa does, at least. All right, comfort foods, top three. Mashed potatoes, Taco Bell tacos, like I already said earlier, and sourdough bread. Just ask Jesse if he comes home and he sees a loaf of sourdough bread from like Safeway or whatever on the counter, he'll be like, she had a bad day, or she's not feeling good. The bread is...
Yeah, but like, you've also left out the version of comfort food that's a 2 liter of Dr. Pepper and a bag of Lay's sour cream and onion potatoes.
I don't do that as much anymore, though.
Yeah, but...
But that was that, yes. Okay, and then we have guilty pleasures. None of my pleasures are guilty. All of my pleasures...
You don't understand guilt.
I don't. I guess one of my guilty pleasures would be rereading the V.C. Andrews novels as an adult.
Can you do a top three V.C. Andrews story?
Rewatching America's Next Top Model, even though I actually like don't even like it that much anymore, but I'll still rewatch it if I'm like tired and not feeling good because it gives me something I can watch and be mindless over. What else? I don't know. Then we've got Starburst flavors. Any of the pink ones or the red ones. I only like red. My favorite kinds of like fruity candy are red or pink. Not red hot, but like strawberry or cherry or whatever. Friday's rainy. 61, 39. Okay. Top three projects. Oh, Jessica asks top three projects for Chrissy Ann Designs. I love doing the celebrations collection every year. The first time I did Steve, which was really fun. And then doing the Vegas. So this last celebrations collection had some of my favorite Steves. And then the Vegas Go Wild when I did Elvis Steve. And I did the neon Steve, which she said wasn't going to look good. And then it looked good. And I was fucking smug. So there's that. 63-37. Sunny on Saturday. Good. What do we got? What else in the comments here? Top three Simply Gilded sub box. I don't know, but I know my favorite sub. I don't remember some of the themes. I'm not. They all blur together to me. But my favorite roles of hers, though, are the coffee and like tea from her first like winter collection. Fucking love that. The sweater, that gray sweater looking one that was like a cross stitch. I fucking love that one too. And that whole set that was like the rainbow foil. The first rainbow foil with like the hearts. Loved that. Sorry, I'm gonna move these comments up because I feel like top three songs from the 1980s, Karen. Oh, how can I do that? Love and Touch and Squeezin' by Journey, my favorite Journey song of all time. Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi. And ooh.
I'm just waiting for you to pick some Peter Cetera.
I wasn't. I was actually going to go with Alone by Heart.
Oh.
How do I get... You know, any of the ones I sing along with in the car. Fuck yeah. And then I saw somebody else ask my favorite disco songs. Where did that one go? Cheryl asked. Top three disco songs. Fucking Bee Gees, baby. Oh my God. More Than a Woman. Tragedy. And You Should Be Dancing, yeah. Fucking love dancing to the Bee Gees. Anything, just give me the Bee Gees. All Bee Gees all the time. Top three favorite people. Oh, of course. My sisters and my Uncle Rich. No, I'm just kidding. Jesse and the kids. And then after Jesse and the kids, it's my sisters and my Uncle Rich. Take On Me, Mary is one of my favorite I'm drunk songs. Like when I'm drunk, I love singing along with Take On Me. No lies. Oh, you love my ring, Die Winslingy? This is my great grandma's wedding ring. Okay, so back to the Instagram. We've got Christmas movies. Elf, Home Alone,
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Yeah, probably Nightmare Before Christmas. I'm actually not a huge Christmas movie fan. I do love Elf though. Jesse has trained me to love Bad Santa. Okay.
He's fantastic.
It's one of his favorite Christmas movies. Okay, I'm gonna start putting some of my tasks in before I keep doing. I'll do some art in a hot minute. Top three kinds of cheese, Mikey. Oh my God. All.
The cheese everything. In front of you right
yes.
Now that's not blue cheese.
Everything that's not blue cheese or feta cheese or Swiss. I don't like Swiss. I'll be fine with baby Swiss, but like regular Swiss cheese is like the fucking hot garbo of cheese. But I just watched The Family Stone for the first time this year, Jamie, and I really liked it. But no, my favorite top three cheeses, if I had to pick my favorite cheeses, it would be St. Andre's cheese, which is triple cream, goddamn good. And then Mount Tam from Cowgirl Creamery. It's another triple cream cheese. Have I given you a... And then the New Zealand white cheddar cheese from... Sharp cheddar cheese from Trader Joe's. Sorry, I don't mean to keep clearing my throat in the microphone, but I'm kind of have to. Top three favorite patrons, Karen. I'm not answering that. Okay. I'd have to answer my father-in-law. He's one of my patrons. I've also sung tub thumping at the top of my lungs, no lie. Katie asked, top three things Jesse does for me. Pick up things that I've dropped so I don't bend over and hurt my kidneys. Make me grilled cheese sandwiches with sourdough bread and fresh mozzarella when I'm not feeling good, which are so goddamn good. And then bring me a bar of soap when I forget to grab a new one when I get in the shower and I yell at him from across the house. He also cleans and maintains the litter box, which is my $500 Christmas present litter box, but he takes care of it because bending over is really hard for me.
Yep.
He does a lot of things for me that are really hard for me right now because of my kidneys. And one day when I get them out, I'm going to have to like learn how to do things again. I'll call it noon. And then I need to work on vectors.
What's your vector, Victor?
And it's my patron thing. And then I have another patron thing. And then I have another patron thing. Upload. Zoom. Yeah. Okay. Top three Jesse made meals. Aforementioned grilled cheese sandwiches. Steaks. Jesse can make a mean motherfucking steak. And he took over making the tomato tortellini soup. He's made it more than I have, and he actually does a really good job on it. What else we got up here?
We got family breakfast in a while, but that was my other like go-to thing.
Top three favorite decades. I have no idea. I actually am really happy right now. I mean, aside from, you know, this situation, but you know. Top three podcasts. You're wrong. Currently, you're wrong about the new one that I'm listening to on Spotify. I think it's called Welcome to Your Fantasy. It's about Chippendales. Hella awesome. And the first season of The Dream. I wasn't really as the second season. It was cool, but it wasn't like really doing it for me. But the first season, I just re-listened to it and it was choice. Top three kid made foods. Cat makes the best chocolate chip cookies. Cat's chocolate chip cookies are outstanding. RJ
can make an omelet.
RJ can make a mean omelet. And that's about it.
And no. You've liked a lot of the every plate stuff.
When they make every plate meals with Jesse, they do a great job. And then I need to film.
Actually, RJ did all the grilled chicken that one week.
Times two. And then comments for the video going live that day. And then I would like to do my creative date that day with myself. Not you, Lulu.
I scooped him.
Planning with Danny asked, top three TV shows from the 80s. Ooh. Perfect Strangers. Perfect Strangers and Perfect Strangers. Fucking love the shit out of Perfect Strangers.
Didn't go Perfect Strangers, Roseanne, Mork, and Mindy.
I can't with Roseanne anymore. I loved it when it was on, but I can't rewatch it now. All I can think about is how much she sucks. Like, same with The Cosby Show. I loved The Cosby Show when it was on in the 80s, but I can't fucking watch it now. I tried to rewatch it, and I can't do it. But fucking love Perfect Strangers. what else? There was.
I thought you were a big Mork and Mindy fan.
No, I liked it. Oh, Remington Steele. Yeah. Remington Steele and was it Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego? Didn't that start in the 80s?
I always think of that as a 90s thing.
Yeah, it kind of is a 90s thing. The Simpsons started in the 80s though, and I watched it when it was first on because I remember watching the shorts on the Tracy Ullman show with my parents. And then we have on this, we have the book club stream on Wednesday, which is going to be a spoiler stream. So if you haven't finished reading Addie LaRue, then I would avoid it if you're in the book club. I did like Alf, Jenny. I was a big fan. Oh, and what other one? Oh, those other shows. Fucking Out of This World. And what was the one with the little girl who was a robot? Out of This World was the one with the alien dad where she could put her fingers together and stop time. And then there was the one with the little girl who was a robot. Small wonder. Those were other 80s shows I loved. Top three things you're looking forward to when living in Colorado. A bigger house. Snow, I think. And having Raising Cane's nearby. Number one, Bond.
Actor or movie?
Yeah. Actor or movie? Actor. I am gonna pick Pierce. His movies sucked ass. Like, most of his movies sucked ass, but I really liked him as Bond because
he
had
the worst material.
Yeah, but he was Remington Steele, and then he was Bond, and I like him, and then he was a Mrs. Doubtfire. But number one Bond movie, my favorite Bond movie, is a Pierce Brosnan movie. I fucking love the shit out of The World Is Not Enough, and I think it's partly because of Pierce Brosnan and partly because I love Garbage, and that was their song. All right, some more from Instagram while I grab my Wednesday to-dos. We have my top three Nightmare on Elm Streets with original Freddy Krueger. That's an easy one to answer. Three, which is the Dream Warriors. Four, which is the Dream Master. And six, Freddy's Dead, The Final Nightmare, because that movie is so ridiculous. I love it. Although Freddy versus Jason is also high on my list of things I'd love. I'm skipping over some of these things just because I've either answered something similar or because I just cannot pull my brain from it. Have I seen today's weather reports from Denver? I've seen a bunch of what's been going on in Denver, and yeah, I'm a little stressed out over it. Don't worry. Three favorite non-essential work items. Non-essential? My magic keyboard for my iPad. It's not essential, but I fucking love it. My new stream deck for my streams. Again, not essential, but I love it. And the leather cover for my bullet journal. Edit. So I want to edit on Wednesday. And then I also want to get my power sheets worked on. And then I have a call. Don't I have a... Oh, I have another call. Wait a minute. Yes. And then we have movie quotes besides Oh Hi Mark. From Anchorman, could all be from Anchorman, but from Anchorman, I love 60% of the time it works every time. Matter of fact, I think we already used that in this stream. From Empire Records, God, again, so many quotes from Empire Records, but my favorite one is, I shouldn't have to explain my art to you, Warren, when he was trying to pick the quarters up off the floor. And then, and then from Face Off, the greatest movie of all time, I could eat a peach for hours. What else we got here? Is that everything for that day? Yeah. All right. And then Thursday. Top three jobs you would loathe, Karen asks. Ooh, probably being a teacher of like kids. I love kids are fine, but like when I was volunteering for my kids' school, I would tell the teachers, give me all your paperwork because I don't want to read with the kids. I don't have the patience for it. Any job that requires that kind of patience, I don't know if I'm good for. So teaching, I feel like I'd be so stressed out. And then actually probably anything. Yeah, teachers, nurses, you guys have patience. I do not. And I guess also going back to nurses, anything that has to do with blood, so phlebotomist, because blood makes me want to barf. So Thursday, I have my patron challenge post. And yes, imperfect foods tomorrow. Thank you for the reminder, Jessica. You always remind me of that, and I appreciate it. Okay, back to the Instagram responses. Favorite American, Animal Crossing villagers. Pietro the clown is my absolute favorite. Pietro, Clay the hamster, and Lucky the ghost dog. And then bullet journal setup I want to work on that day. Ooh, I never checked to see which one won from my patron post. I'll have to look at that after this. And comments. I'm doing some batch filming this week because I'm trying to get ahead of things. I'll talk more about that in an upcoming video. And then we have here... top three favorite songs to sing. Okay, this, you might think it was going to be like the songs I like to sing in the car, but I'm actually thinking about the songs I sang with like my quintet, because those were rad. I fucking love singing Dix Ratons, which is a French poem situation. I think it's by Rainer Maria Rilke? And then there was A Dream of Rain. Another one we did. I really loved singing that one. And then there was Celtic Loud. Those three songs with my quartet or my quint, any of the groups I've sang. Oh, and then what was the other one that we did? Lead Me Home was another one that I did with the choir I sang with. I love singing those. But if you're talking about like pop songs, All My Life by Casey and JoJo, we'll go back to, and then Faithfully by Journey and Always by Bon Jovi are the ones I like to sing in the car. Just adding in these Friday tasks. And. Okay. So, and then we have the weekend. Top three Pitch Perfect movies in order. The first one, the second one, and the third one. Because, yeah. When you voted The Willow was... really? Wow. Wasn't... okay, so coming into here, potato chips. Ooh, sour cream and onion Lay's, nacho cheese Doritos, and like kettle cooked, just regular chips. Depending, the brand is not as important, but like kettle cooked chips. What? Oh, you're talking to cats?
I'm not scolding you to get off the kitchen table.
Wash sheets. And then we have, as per usual, we have hangout. So one of the top things that's going to happen this week is we got to get our April trip planned. Live plan with me, 2:30 p.m. Okay, got some, I'm gonna do some drawing. Let's do some drawing. I do have that, Emily. I just haven't used it yet. So we'll go back into here. Somebody asked, bullet journal pens, new minimal bullet journal here. I like fine-tipped Pigma Microns, mostly. I use just an assortment of like 005, 01, and 02. Fineliners, and the three sets of fineliners I tend to use the most are Tombow monoliners, Pigma Microns, and the Pigeon Letters monoliners. I really like those. Top three fantasy book series. I really love A Song of Ice and Fire and A Wheel of Time. I haven't read. Oh, and The Dark Tower by Stephen King. Okay, so definitely plane tickets. Hotel, rental car, UCSF, because I need to do that. Have I had Jay's potato chips? No. All right, so what do we got? We got funny stories. My top three funny stories about Kat and RJ when they were younger than 8 or so. Oh.
Easter Bunny story. The Easter Bunny letter.
Okay, yes. There was the Easter Bunny letter that Kat wrote about, like, Easter Bunny poops.
Yeah, I convinced Kat that jelly beans were Easter Bunny poop.
Yes, so Kat wrote a letter to the Easter Bunny, and it was really funny. My cousin saved a picture of it. There was the wiener hand incident where RJ had his hand down his pants as a little guy and then pulled his hand out and wiped it on Kat, and Kat yelled at him about their about being touched with RJ's wiener hand.
Screech, yeah.
That one was really good. And then there was the time in IKEA when Jesse and I were first dating where RJ was with us as a little guy and he ate an IKEA hot dog. I'm gonna have to get my face on here for this one. He ate an IKEA hot dog and he started choking on it, and I whacked him on the back of the head and he whoo, and like coughed it into my hand and then looked at it and then ate it back out of my hand. Those are some of my favorite stories with those kids. That is you, Heather. I see your hairdo. Okay, songs to listen to when sad. Kissing You from the Romeo plus Juliet soundtrack. That's one of them. Anything by Elton John, but a lot of Elton John songs like Daniel
songs
or...
to make you sad or when you are already...
It says when sad. Well, I guess those ones make me sad. You're right. To Pump Me Up, though, Dawn by Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons pumps me up when I'm sad, and anything by the Bee Gees. Well, from their disco era. Fun fact, Deborah, I actually talk about Mists of Avalon in my book Declutter very specifically. All right, so scrolling through here, let's pick some more. We've got breakfast foods when you don't cook them. Bacon. I fucking hate cooking bacon. Bacon, those shredded hash browns, and pancakes. Easy. I don't like making any of those. Or I just don't make them as good as I would want to. Okay. Just looking at the stuff I need to move forward. Mm-hmm. Gotta do our family cookbook cover this week.
Was I supposed to do something?
No, you're fine. Don't worry about it.
I get a pass because you're cool, right?
How long does it take you to read It by Stephen King? Not very long, but I've read it multiple times and I'm a speed reader. Yeah, real ID is not required till October. I know I need to read Sanderson. I know. Okay, top three go-to dinners. Chicken gnocchi soup. Tacos. And breakfast for dinner. Top three not a cat mom essentials. We've got, our new gigantic cat tree from Chewy is amazing. Right, boys? Is it amazing? And then the flat.
Neither of them are sitting on it.
No, they're not. They're both sitting on my office boxes right now. Here, we'll show you again. I've got a kitty there and a kitty there. And behind these boxes is the cat tree. But the other kitty essentials, the other kitty essentials would be the flanyard, like the stick with the piece of flannel on it. And two, three. And a good, like, furry or chenille blanket that they can make hella muffins on. That would be my situation. I do bacon in the oven. I still hate making it. top three wallpaper backgrounds for my computer. I'm actually really partial to the ones I do for my patrons. I make them because I like them. And the one I liked the most recently was, I believe, the one for January with the watercolor flowers, or maybe it was December. But I tend to like ones that I change. I have like websites bookmarked on my page that I change out the icons for, and I just like to have a very soothing. I just changed out the colors on my Google Calendar for everything to be very soothing. So that's just the life I'm living right now. I'm going to make a really big daffodil this week, I think. For some reason, this is more difficult than I thought it was going to be to try and keep it right, but that's okay. Ooh, hello from Oakland. Top three wild animals. Whoa. Monkeys. Great white sharks. And... fuck my life. I don't even know. Probably another shark. Probably mako sharks or potentially some other shark. Sharks are my favorite animal. Not dolphins, though. My fucking grandma and my uncle somehow got this idea that I like dolphins, which is not the case. Dolphins are, I like sharks, but they kept giving me dolphin related swag for like every birthday and Christmas for the longest time, including my first wedding. My grandma gave me this like fleecy, heavy, really nice blanket with dolphins on it. Like, my grandma gave me that blanket for our wedding, and I let my ex-husband keep it when we divorced because it's a really nice blanket. And he knew as well as I did that I don't fucking care for dolphins that much. Top three sexy actresses. Let me think. I think that, what is her fucking name? Oh my God, why am I brain farting? Fucking kidney brain. She's on Saturday Night Live and really goddamn hilarious. And she was in the new Ghostbusters movie. This could be two of them, actually. Leslie Jones is one of them. I think Leslie Jones is fucking sexy with how funny she is and how tall and like awesome she is. But the other one also, she plays fucking Jeff Sessions. God, what is her name? Why am I brain farting on it?
Kate McKinnon.
Yes, Kate McKinnon. Kate McKinnon is fucking sexy. She is rad. And Leslie Jones, Kate McKinnon, and she's not an actress, but I don't care. She's my, like, I would be, like, my potential lesbian. Like, I'm fairly straight. I'm pretty straight, I'm sure. But if I was ever to be, like, bisexual... Okay. Huh? Yeah, it would be for Shirley Manson. Jesse knows it too. Jesse knows
it. Okay.
Shirley Manson is my out clause. Shirley Manson, John Bon Jovi, and Idris Elba are like my out clauses in our relationship. Not Kristen Wiig. It's Kate McKinnon. Thank you. Yeah, you guys all got it. I could have named so many people. Yeah, she is so talented, and that's part of it for me, but it's also just that she's fucking rad. All right, so from Instagram, we have animated movies. Actually, probably none of them are Disney. I fucking love the Don Bluth movies. The Secret of Nim is probably my favorite animated movie of all time. I love The Secret of Nim so very, very much. I love The Land Before Time so very, very much. And I love An American Tale, Fievel Goes West, so very, very much.
Fravel Goes West.
That's what the kids used to call him. They called him Fravel. March. That was his March weather. Have I seen Coming to America? No, I have not watched that yet. Week 11. (Clears throat) liked the new Ghostbusters. I understand that, like, some people didn't like it, but, like, I actually thought it was fun. You know, I thought it was fun. I thought that the cast was hilarious. I thought that Chris Hemsworth was having a good old time, and it showed. And I mean, believe me.
He was having the most fun of anybody.
He was. But, like, I love the old Ghostbusters movies. I fucking love Bill Murray. And I love Harold Ramis. And I love Dan Aykroyd. And I love Ernie Hudson. And I love Annie Potts. And I love Rick Moranis. You know, like, I have so much love for the old Ghostbusters. But, like, I thought that a lot of the discourse around the new Ghostbusters was, I felt that at least some of it was hella fucking sexist. So, I'm not saying it was all sexist, but I am saying that there was a definite undertone of sexistness. I'm going to color code my shit right now. What page am I up to in my barren fig? Ooh, hi, I'm glad you're here, Elizabeth. I don't know. I don't think I'm halfway there yet, Rebecca. I'm pretty sure I might be a third of the way through it. I have not been writing, excuse me, I've not been writing page numbers down, though, because that's too much work. All right, so pulling off some more from things you'll miss in California. That's a good one. Top three things I'm going to miss in California. I've already mentioned sourdough. I'm terrified of sourdough. This is mostly work stuff I've written in here. I don't actually think I've put in much else because I'm just going to do that as the week goes on. So, planning videos, making vectors. And then we have ripple, edit. Top three want to meet actors. That's an interesting one. Oh, I forgot to finish my top three of California. So things I'm going to miss in California are sourdough, most definitely. I'm going to miss the driving distance to my sister's. Flying distance is not bad at all to either place, but driving distance, I could get in the car and drive to see either my sister's. One would take a couple hours, one would take 8 hours, but it would be a much more than that to drive there. So that's something I'm going to miss. And being within a couple hours of the beach. Not that it's like the California beaches are not exactly like the Northern California beaches are not like the fun in the sun that you see on like the TV shows and shit. They are, much more cold and chilly, but that is something I like. So, yeah. Pam, the colors are the time batching categories I've set up, and then I'm just tracking them up here by 10-minute increments. So, yeah, top three favorite want-to-meet actors. I've met a bunch of the actors I wanted to meet, but I would love to meet... I don't know if I'd love to meet Nicolas Cage, because I've learned that when you meet people, sometimes you, your heroes get knocked off of pedestals. I'd love to meet Chris Evans because he looks like he would be good times. I would love to meet Bill Murray because, again, he looks like he would be hella good times. And who else? God, I keep mentioning her, but I would love to meet Janelle Monáe. Like, hell yeah, I would love to meet Janelle Monáe. David and the Lost Boys would disagree with your assessment of the California beaches. God damn, dude. Like, that movie, The Lost Boys, is so... Like, you could tell how much it was filmed around fucking Santa Cruz when you watch it. Oh, it's so bad. I love it, but it's just so obvious. All right, so scrolling through here, a lot of the same things. A lot favorite moving supplies. I haven't moved yet, but thus far, packing paper. My favorite moving supply would be a tape gun that doesn't hate me, which I currently don't have. So that's something I will be finding, hopefully. But at the moment, my tape gun hates me. But I imagine I would enjoy a tape gun more. I don't know why I just did that. That has nothing there, but that's okay. We'll figure it out. And the moving binder. I'm really, those printables, they're very helpful so far. Favorite TV networkers, like the networks or the people on it? I guess my favorite TV networks would be HBO because it has most of the stuff I want. And Stars, because it has like the White Queen and the Spanish Princess and all that. And AMC, just because it's the one that I was able to get Discovery of Witches off of. But if it's people on networks, it would be Steve Kornacki, Brian Williams on MSNBC because he's fucking snarky, and I really enjoy Rachel Maddow. So if that tells you anything about my politics, then there you go. Top three things I'm looking forward to in Denver. Yeah, I did do that already, so you can go back and find that one. It's towards the beginning, I'm pretty sure. Those are all moving related. And then let's see, let's scroll through some more, find some more. Top three songs of your teen years. Ooh. So I was a teenager in the 90s, and my top three songs would probably be Black by Pearl Jam. I love that song. Black by Pearl Jam. Friend is a four-letter word by Cake. And Killing in the Name of by Rage Against the Machine. Favorite kids shows I used to watch: Animaniacs, Tiny Toons, and Batman the Animated Series. Don't even have to think about that one. Scrolling through here. Top three bands or artists: Muse, Cake, and Weird Al. Top three things on your when I win the lottery list. Pay off my house, whatever house I'm in. Pay off my house. Set aside money for retirement and my kids. And get Jesse a Tesla because he really wants one. And then we've got top three textures to feel, love or hate. Well, they're all hate. I really hate most textures, but I really hate the feel of newsprint. I hate the feel of pastels. And I hate that like soft matte kind of like weird cross between like velvet and cardstock that's on like some of the books you get from Amazon. Blah. Any favorite anime? Anime puts me to sleep. The only anime I loved as a kid was Sailor Moon, but like my ex loved anime, my kids both love anime, and I fall asleep every time I try to watch it. I don't know why. I don't know. I can't figure it out. Top three favorite flowers. Ooh, that's a hard one. I love California poppies. I love ranunculus. I think the colors are gorgeous, and I love dahlias, but specifically the dahlia variations that have like the different colors where like the tips are dark, but then it gets lighter as you go towards the center of the flower. But I love most flowers. Like, to be honest, I love most flowers.
You didn't name calla lilies.
I've kind of like grown away from calla lilies. I'm starting to love color in my flowers, and I think it's because of doing all the paintings and everything. Top three Halloween movies as a kid. I started watching horror movies when I was very young. So most, I love any horror movies at Halloween. Doesn't matter how shitty they are, but like non-scary Halloween movies would be Hocus Pocus. And I don't know. Most of the movies I like at Halloween are scary. Like I love the entire Halloween series. That's not true. I don't love the entire Halloween series, but I will watch the entire Halloween series. Except for number three, that's right. And the Nightmare on Elm Street series, the fucking Friday the 13th series, the Child's Play series, the I like Sleepaway Camp movies, I like the Prom Night movies. Hello Mary Lou Prom Night 2 is fucking ridiculously off the chain silly, and I love it. Like, I love horror movies. Like, I love cheeseball, especially 80s, like when the slasher movie was at its heyday and studios were pumping out the most ridiculous slasher movies ever. I loved it. I'm not as big of a fan of the torture porn kind of situation that got really popular around like Saw and Hostel. Not a big fan of that. And I'm not a big fan of the found footage style because it makes me super nauseated. Although the more recent like renaissance of horror movies with It and Get Out and Us and Midsommar and all those movies has been really fun. Have I seen Saturday the 14th? I fucking love the shit out of Saturday the 14th. Yeah, I love that movie. My family had that on VHS when I was a kid, and we watched the shit out of Saturday the 14th. And if you've never seen it, I believe it's streaming on Prime right now, and it is worth every no penny of it. Oh, it's so funny. I love it so much. Oh, my God. Thank you for bringing it up. Thank you for bringing it up. Ready or Not was awesome. Yeah, thank you for bringing up Saturday the 14th. I fucking love that movie so much. Do I love that movie? And by the way, Kat watched Get Out with their friends the other day because he had to watch it for school. I don't remember what it was for school, but he had to watch it for school. And they were like doing like the online watch party. And I was curious about it because Kat normally pieces out really quickly with any kind of scary movie. Kat cannot handle them. But Kat loved Get Out. Like, Kat loved it. So that was interesting. I'm just writing down my meal plan for the week. Well, for some of the week. Oh my God, I have the hiccups. I'm sorry. The refilming of Carrie. Oh, nice. Yeah. Saturday the 14th is the fucking jam. It's so good. Okay, I'm going to pick a couple more from Instagram, and then I'm going to get going because I got other things I got to get working on tonight. Top three Stephen King books. So I already said It, but besides It, Bag of Bones. I love its like analysis of grief. Pet Sematary, again, because of its way of talking about grief, and it was also the first one I ever read. I hid it under the bed when I was 8. And, God... Misery, probably. Love Misery. So good. Have I seen Right Said Fred? Like, the music? Like, isn't that the guy who sings I'm Too Sexy for My Shirt? Or are you talking about that other Right, the other Fred movie? Okay, we got this one. Favorite 80s movies. Oh, God. So many of my favorite 80s movies are so fucking problematic now. And I've watched them as an adult and been like, the fuck was I thinking? But I guess I would go with The Goonies. The Monster Squad, one of my favorite movies ever. And The Goonies, The Monster. Oh, how can I forget? Fucking Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Wayne's World is not an 80s movie. That came out in 1990, and I know that because I saw it when it came out in the theater at a double feature with that and Star Trek The Undiscovered Country because my parents were cool. I know what you're talking about. The undead, it's like not Right Said Fred. It's like, oh, God, what is that movie called? Doesn't it have like Phoebe Cates in it? I haven't seen it, but I know what you're talking about. It's not Carrot Top, but it's some guy that looks like Carrot Top. Did I ever watch, no, The Young Ones on MTV in the 80s? No, I do not remember watching that. All right. Let me see if there's any of these I can just pick out really quick. Jesse, what are your top three favorite wines? Somebody asked for you.
I'll go categories, but I'll say Provence rosé, or like dry French rosé. And give me an awesome Argentine Malbec for relentless beef. And, oh man, life is too short to live yourself with three favorite wines, but I will, I haven't picked a Pinot Noir yet, so I'll give it like a Carneros Pinot Noir. It's number three.
Yeah. I have not seen Drop Dead Fred, but I know about that movie. I remember when it came out. Okay, so I am done with my spread for the week. I will answer one more from here, and that is ingredients for cooking, because I remember seeing this one and remembering I wanted to mention this one. My top three favorite ingredients for cooking are garlic, fucking garlic for days, grated Parmesan cheese, not the stuff you get on the shelf stable, but like freshly, either freshly grated or like the refrigerated grated Parmesan cheese like you get from Trader Joe's. And lately I have been a huge fan of the combination of like, I love, I guess oregano is like my other, I overuse oregano, probably. Anyway, I'll give you one more too. Top three favorite car ride activities: singing along with music. I generally sing along with like, all of count, like not all, the first six songs on every August and Everywhere Else from Counting Crows. And I'll put on a musical and sing through the whole thing while I'm driving. Sleeping, and that's about it. Because if I read when I'm driving, I can't, or if I, not when, I, when I'm driving, or listening to a podcast, I guess. But if I try to read or play video games or do anything else while we're driving, and I get car sick. So, yeah. Are we going to try and sell our house before we move? Yes. Am I going to miss Trader Joe's? I haven't been working there in 4 years, and there's Trader Joe's in the area we're moving to, so I'm not worried about it. Anyway, I'm going to get going. This was fun. Thank you so much. I will see you next week, and make sure to like this on the way out the door. And until next time, also subscribe. I will see you.